And welcome back. Texans love their state for a lot of good reasons, but outsiders find us puzzling, I guess. Good morning to the man who made it his mission to explain it all to the world in this book, God Save Texas, Lawrence Wright, a Pulitzer Prize-winning writer, staff writer for The New Yorker, but he has a good side because he still lives in Austin. Donald Trump won by less than you might think over Hillary Clinton. That's in right. Texas. Is this state going to become purple or blue anytime soon, do you think?
Well, it will turn. You know, the demography is clear. You know, it's the cities that are growing and the cities are blue. So, you know, inevitably, Texas will turn purple at least and then blue. It was blue when I was a child here in Dallas.
Yes.
And, you know, and California was red. People forget, you know, that Texas gave birth to Lyndon Johnson, who created the Great Society. And California produced Ronald Reagan and the modern conservative revolution. So these two states, you know, revolve around each other, and really the whole country is determined by the politics and the relation of Texas and California.
Yeah, it is fascinating. You talk a lot about the culture here in Texas, not just the politics, but the culture. I called it a love letter to a crazy girlfriend, because you love the state, but you kind of go sometimes are beating your head against the wall.
I might use that as a blurb. I love that. You know, I'm in a band and we play Texas music, and you know, so it's one side of Texas that that I just adore and without reservation. And I spent a lot of time driving around the state, and I remember I went to Wink, Texas, which is where Roy Orbison is from. Yeah. And there's a Roy Orbison Museum, which is practically the only building standing in Wink. And they have his glasses in there that I was allowed to put on, those dark glasses that he wore. And then I went to Lubbock, and Joe Ely, this great singer-songwriter, yeah, took me. He was going to show me where the music comes from, because Lubbock is the mother lode. And we went into the Walmart, and we walked past the baby strollers and we came to the diapers, and he said, right here was Buddy Holly's house.
Seriously.
So there's no plaque, I fear.
As you go through, there was a fascinating story in there that I actually did pay attention in seventh grade Texas history, yeah, but I missed this one. Why Texas joined the Union as opposed to remaining a republic?
Well, Texas is broke. And Great Britain offered Texas the opportunity to bail them out with a giant loan on the condition that they pay wages for all their labor. In other words, no slavery.
No slavery.
And Texas passed up that opportunity. They were also allowed, you know, they could have remained a part of Mexico, but Mexico had outlawed slavery as well. So they went into the Union as a slave state. And, you know, I'm happy that Texas became a part of the United States, but for all the secessionists who have fantasized about breaking away, it was slavery that that caused Texas to become a state.
You suggest in here that Texas is the future of the country.
Yeah.
How do you see that?
Well, it's been growing like crazy forever. And you know, California has 55 electoral votes, but that hasn't changed since 2003. That's the largest state. The third largest, New York, has been losing population, electoral votes, and influence for decades. Texas has 39 electoral votes now. We're expected to get 43 in the next census.
Wow.
The population of Texas is expected to double by 2050, at which time we'll be the size almost of California and New York combined. 10% of all the students in America right now are Texans. So in every respect, Texas is the future.
And yet, the Texas public education system really struggles.
This is shameful, honestly. We pay less per student than any other state in the union. Well, 49th out of 50.
Yeah.
And what do we get out of that? You know, Nation's report card came out, you know, like 10 days ago, and we are, I believe, 41st in the eighth grade and 45th in the fourth grade. Those are our future workers. They're our future Texans.
Right.
And they are the future of America.
And they're the people that will be working for the companies that we hope to attract with our attractive workforce.
Companies go to where there are good schools. And if we don't provide that kind of education for our future, then we have a darker future.
More on the book, God Save Texas. We have a link to the book as well on fox4news.com.
Thank you.
Fascinating stories in there. If you think you know Texas, You will by the end of this book. Thanks for it.
Letter to a Crazy Girlfriend. Thank you.
All right, we've got more to come.